Day Street Books and Harper Audio present Be Your Best Self, the official companion to the New York Times bestseller, Best Self, by Mike Bayer. Read by Will Damron, with an introduction read by the author.
A note before we begin. Don't forget to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/audio/be-your-best-self. It contains exercises from the book and will be referred to throughout as the enhancement. Introduction. Who are you? We rarely, if ever, slow down enough in our lives to really ask ourselves that question. But that is the central goal of this workbook: to take the time, do the work, and have the reward of discovering what makes you uniquely you. One of the observations I've had over 2 decades of working with people is that our external world will match how aligned we are with our authentic self. For example, if you don't believe that you are worthy of close, true friends, you will isolate yourself a lot in your social life. This will prevent you from having those meaningful friendships. Or, if you have low self-esteem, you will create a life in which you are surrounded by people and things that validate your low opinion. In other words, however you feel internally will be mirrored externally because of your choices, whether conscious or subconscious. Our society likes to focus on hugely popular celebrities who seem like they have it all, who are wildly successful and wealthy, travel all over the world, and live what seem to be amazing lives. The reality is that many of these people are totally miserable inside. We've all heard those stories, and they seem so unbelievable from an outside perspective. How could he/she be depressed and suicidal? He's got millions in the bank and international fame. But let's reframe that question in terms of the external environment matching our internal beliefs I just discussed. If you were to peel back the layers of glitz and glamour and really see that person's life up close, what you might discover is that his or her immediate surroundings and their day-to-day existence perpetuate their misery. In other words, they spend time engaging in unhealthy behaviors, people, places, and things. And it's all because of one big problem. He or she isn't aligned with their authentic self, their best self. No amount of material, external success can ever solve that problem. You have to dig deep and identify your best self within and create the life that honors that version of yourself. On the other hand, consider the person who is just getting by, but leaps out of bed in the morning feeling off the charts, content and happy with their life because they are living each day as his or her best self. Perhaps he or she takes time to experience the power of gratitude, to stay intimately connected with loved ones, to give back to the community, and to maintain self-care and emotional balance. Cultivating this kind of authentic life does not require monetary wealth, perfect physical health, or anything other than a commitment to live as our best self. The point is, we create our reality, and what the world sees when they look at us is far from the whole story. If there was a news story about you today, it wouldn't be the whole story, right? That would be impossible to capture. Others would have no idea what's really going on in your life or in your head. Only you can know if you're choosing to live as your best self so that you can squeeze every last drop of vitality, love, and inspiration out of this life. And only you can know what is holding you back if you aren't. This is the workbook companion guide to best self, Be You Only Better. In my first book, I wanted to help readers clearly define, deeply connect with, and learn to live each day as their best self. I knew from all of the thousands of hours I'd spent working with people across every imaginable walk of life, dealing with an extremely wide range of obstacles, that most issues in life come from a lack of connection with our authenticity. I believed if I could just help folks get to know who they are at their core, that they would then hold the key to creating a life they'd only dreamed of. I was feeling exhilarated when the book went into print because I knew that if only one person's life improved as a result of what I'd written, then it was a total win. But I could never have predicted the unique and compelling stories of transformation that have poured in from the world on my Facebook and Instagram platforms. I continue to be deeply humbled and honored by the results. My mission has always been to help people discover the freedom to be the best version of themselves, and I've now communicated with thousands of people who feel they've done just that as a result of the work they did in Best Self. I said the work they did. I didn't do the work for them, and I can't do it for you, but we can do it together. And that's exactly why I wanted to create this companion. When I reviewed Best Self, I saw opportunities to go further into the concept so that you can unlock more truths about yourself and find new applications for the wisdom you've gained. Yes, it would be helpful for you to read that book first, but it's not required in order to use the exercises in this workbook. What is required is for you to be curious, open, honest, willing, and focused to go on this journey. I want to help you discover exactly how you can be you, only better, in order to feel fully equipped for navigating anything and everything that happens in life. We can't ever predict what's coming our way, but we can choose to live authentically so that we are actively creating a life we want, and that matches our intentions. If you follow Coach Mike Bearer on any of my social media platforms, which I encourage you to do, then you'll see that I share positive content meant to help you accomplish just this and how I strive to do the same. If right now you're thinking, yeah, but I don't have time, or yeah, but I have so much baggage from my past, or yeah, but my circumstances are too complicated, then I would say this: I'm not here to convince you. If you're a yeah, but person, then I can't help you. You can either choose to live in your rut, your anger, or your pain, or you can choose to turn your negativity into inspiration. But openness is an essential ingredient in this recipe for authentic living. The more open you are to the possibilities and to the process, the more opportunities you'll uncover. So before you start to really sync up your life with who you are, you need to get to know yourself. I'll break the ice right now and share with you how I see myself. I'm a spirit who is fun, clever, artistic, out of the box, determined, resilient, and ever evolving. That's who I am. And importantly, that's who I tell myself I am. Because who you are can't be based upon other people's perceptions of you. You're in charge of your own narrative. I love how resilient I am. Of course, I don't love going through difficulty, but I know I have a choice. If something bad happens, I can choose to wallow and get stuck, or I can say to myself, okay, I will accept this and I will live in this for right now, and then I'm going to find inspiration and I'm going to move through it and grow from it. The latter is the choice I make. That, I believe, is resiliency. It's one of a multitude of topics I often dive into with guests on the Coach Mike Bearer podcast with the theme of always evolving. And I invite you to listen and hear for yourself some of the fascinating conversations I've had with folks from many industries and parts of the world. I've loved having the opportunity to delve into the human psyche and our extraordinary capacity to live as our best self with people who have beaten the odds, risen above their circumstances, pivoted into new and unexpected directions, or reinvented their lives from the inside out. Overhaulers, underdogs, superstars, up-and-comers, waymakers, and trailblazers alike, they all have a story, and they are all powered by an authenticity battery just like you and me. We have so much to learn from one another's journeys, and I'm thrilled to offer a platform for sharing those stories and insights. When we think about who we are, often we say things like, I'm a mom, I'm a daughter, I'm a sister, I'm a son, which are all aspects of someone's life, but they are roles we play relative to someone else. Being a son does not define who I am as a spirit. Yes, I'm a son, but only until I don't have parents anymore. I'm a son only in relation to my parents. It is still important, as are all the roles we play, certainly. But it is not the essence of me, the core of my authentic self. Through the exploration you'll do within this book, I hope you will be able to figure out who you are on the most essential, soulful level. I find that most people only think about who they really are when they are feeling stuck in some aspect of life. Why wait until there's a problem? Why not take the time now to cultivate and create a rich understanding of yourself? I think of this as your best self life guidebook. The work you'll be doing here, should you be willing and curious enough to do it, is more important than any workbook you ever completed in school. And no textbook was ever written that contained information superior to what you could potentially learn here. Why? Because this book is about you. It's about discovering your truth, becoming your best self, and then living the life you were meant to live. The first time I encountered a workbook that meant something to me on the level that this one could mean to you was when I was beginning my journey toward getting sober. I dug into every single exercise, allowed myself to be completely vulnerable in my answers, and made it my top priority above all else. I knew I didn't want to go back to the half-life I'd been leading. I saw each page I completed in the workbook as another step out of the darkness. Before you ask, no, this is not a rehab workbook. It is not designated solely or even specifically for those who are working toward freedom from the stranglehold of addiction. This is a guide that can reveal answers to questions you haven't even known to ask, and regardless of where you're starting from, it can take you where you've always wanted to go. Bottom line, if you're looking to relaunch, rediscover, or reinvent any aspect of your life, then this workbook can be your springboard. But you only get out of it what you put in. This process doesn't have to be arduous. In fact, you should fully expect to have some laugh-out-loud moments while you're exploring this book. Change can and should be fun. Figuring out what makes us tick and connecting dots we've never seen before is exhilarating. Yes, you have to dig up the past and closely examine your present, but envisioning a greater future is powerful. This journey is about opening up new channels of our imagination. It's about uncovering our hidden talents, desires, and needs, and activating them to improve our lives. In Best Self, the book, the very first exercise is to design your own best self. You describe him or her in great detail and even draw a picture. Before you start this companion guide, return to that exercise and transfer your own best self onto the space provided in the enhancement. Get creative. Even get out your art supplies if you want to. The way I've organized this companion guide is by the seven spheres of life. Spheres is an acronym. Social, personal, health, education, relationship, employment, spiritual. Together, we are going to delve deeper into each area of your life so that you can more completely connect and sync up your best self within those spheres. You may already know which of your spheres are the most out of balance, as evidenced by issues you're having in specific parts of your life. I've found that to be true in the Best Self coaching group on Facebook. For sure, most folks know right off the bat which are the most troublesome spheres for them. You may, of course, begin your work within the spheres that most urgently require your attention. Or you can work through this workbook in order. The choice is yours. We all behave differently in different settings, but if you're acting in a way that runs contrary to who you are authentically in a particular area of your life, and that feels uncomfortable, that's an indication that you might be out of balance in that area. If that is the case, I urge you to focus there first. But again, what you get out of this workbook is what you put into it. The idea is to build upon the work you did in Best Self and find new ways that you can feel aligned with your passions and authenticity. The most important thing to keep in mind as you progress is to approach each exercise in this book as your best self. If you did the work in the book, then you are familiar with your best self and your anti-self. All of us have at least one anti-self, that side of ourselves that is driven by ego, fear, and other negative forces. It has nothing to do with who we really are, but certain triggers can cause us to slip into old habits or thought patterns that don't serve us. If you begin to feel your anti-self sneaking in or trying to take over, take a moment to center yourself. For me, when that begins to happen, one of the ways I can most quickly wrestle my anti-self down is to write about it. What triggered this? What feelings did I experience that might have brought my anti-self to the forefront? How do I push him away? One of my anti-selves is named Angelus. I think of him as a male witch. He isolates, lacks inspiration, lacks purpose, and blames others for how he feels.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.